thank you for the meat of God.
Power and love.
to show him those words that he needs to say, that you'll give him the ability to say it in such a way that it would cause us to believe what you have said, and then help us to be able to obey what you taught us. So we thank you for our preacher. We thank you for teaching him as he teaches us. We thank you for those that will be participating in the word and the music, that they will be singing as unto yourself. And then, Father, we pray that our worship will be one that will cause you to be satisfied with it. Accept our worship, we pray. Accept our praise. We thank you very much for what you've done for us. We thank you for the week's activity. We thank you for last night's sleep and rest. But more than that, we thank you for this morning, for this Resurrection Sunday, for the time that Jesus Christ rose from the dead so that we could become believers in Jesus Christ. So we thank you for that. And now, Father, we pray that as we move through this time of worship, that you will honor our prayers, that you will answer them, because we know that you will, we know that you can. So we ask that you answer our prayers according to your riches and glory by Christ Jesus. Lord, we love you very much. We love you because you first loved us and sent Jesus Christ into the world to live for us, to die for us. And we thank you that he rose again from the dead, and now he lives forevermore, and your Holy Spirit lives within us. So accept our worship, we pray. Bless us, we pray, in the name of Jesus Christ, and for his sake we pray. Amen.
Nobody knows your testimony. And even those who think they know me don't know all of mine. But one thing that I know, I heard the pastor preach about a universal language of praise. And that when we offer that up to God, he hears. The angels know our cries. God knows everything about us, and yet we still know. So if you can't sit up, if your head too big, your shoes too high, your suit too pretty, just come along and pray.
When it counted most. After that, Peter's failure hung over his head like a dark cloud. He was ready to quit because he felt like a failure. He gave up following and went back to fishing. In one episode, they fished all night with no success. But then, when they were about to give up, Jesus showed up. Peter got another chance. Perhaps you're sitting next to somebody today who came looking for another chance. Can I get you to bless them on Easter Sunday? Tell them you got another chance, neighbor.
Can I walk with you to a new life?
The doors of the church are open.